Bears Alliance kicker Austin Seibert to do the honors, and we are underway now at Ford Field. Taking it about the one. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. A first carry for Leonard Fournette. And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Gronkowski, and they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. There's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man, and this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. To throw is Brady. Got a man complete to Miller. And he is able to take this way down into Detroit territory. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. We know he's good at catching the football, but then after the catch, he's got escapability.
Not only that, he's got some toughness as well, because you know he's coached very hard to make sure he battles through, breaks tackles, and then they finish with, but don't fumble the football.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. They'll try and run for it with Fournette, and he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette, a 5-yard touchdown run, and the Bucs take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Extra point put through by Succop, and that makes the score 7-0. Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. For the first time with DeAndre Swift. And a good physical run that time. He's going to wind up gaining 5 on that one.
46-yard line. It's a gain of 5. brings up second and five.
A play fake for Swift. Now Goff. And down he goes. A Buccaneer sack. So now following the sack, Goff and the Lions needing to come up with something here on third and long. They'll fake the give. Now Goff. Open man here is Benson. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
On first down, it's gone.
That's into the hands of Cohen Freeman.
And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there.
It's a gain of seven. Brings up second and three.
On second down, Swift. And give him about three as he gets it down to the 22-yard line.
Brings up third down.
Goff on third down.
They'll find Swift out of the backfield.
And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8.
Complete to DeAndre Swift. First and goal.
Back to throw. Goff.
They'll try and set up the screen to Swift.
And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. It'll go as a loss on the play. Not what you need down here. It's going to be second and goal. Steps away to his left. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Now Goff on third and goal. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there. And now fourth down. On now is Seibert for the Lion field goal. From the left hand, should be a fairly easy one here. Seibert's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So, yes, it's only three, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
This will be fielded inside the 5. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
Brings up second and 7 at the 28-yard line.
Second and 6. No, scratch that. Second and 7.
Back to the ground, this time to Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards a yard. Throwing now is Brady. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
When you get a big tight end like this, sometimes it takes more than one man to bring him down. Oftentimes, your best bet, just jump on and hold on and wait for your teammates to arrive to help get him on the ground.
And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop it right around the line of scrimmage. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up 2nd and 12. Brady going to throw.
This one swung out here to Jones.
And he'll get it down here to the 43.
A gain of 10 yards.
So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. Now Brady. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
While the ultimate result was an incomplete pass, they sure look like a well-coached team, because once he got outside of the pocket, the scramble rules come into effect. And a lot of the guys who ran deep routes, they come back closer to the line of scrimmage. And the running back usually runs a check down. He took it deep, and they gave it a big shot and came up unsuccessful.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's finally taken down, but not before he reaches the 14. A big play there for Detroit.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure's good, forcing the quarterback out of the pocket. But it's a lot to ask for these defenders to stay plastered to receivers long enough. And sure enough, they let a man come open, and the connection leads to a big play.
He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. Quintez Cephas there to make the grab. And the Lions have taken the lead. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And the lead is now 10-7. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. From the 10. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Set to begin their next possession as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Brady's throw on target to Godwin here. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. On first down, Brady.
Well, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
Again, it's Brady. Howard has the first down and then some. And down to the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Brady. Escaping the pressure right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's Brady. Godwin's got it. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Chris Godwin in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bucs are going to retake the lead. Extra point up and good by Succop. And the lead is now 14-10.
So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away.
And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone. So we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
And with only 9 seconds remaining, well, not much time, we'll see how they play this.
On first and 10, Goff. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And the Bucs are going to take over here at their own 22-yard line.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there. You throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
Final adjustments being made in both locker rooms. They are just about set to get back to football in Detroit. And for the call of the second half, we'll kick it back up to Ford Field and Brandon Gunn.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number 3. It'll be Lions football to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And it'll come out to the 25 as Raymond will elect not to bring it out. Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive.
They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for.
Fights through and now a crease. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A big play that time on the catch and run.
Well, so often now we're praising tight ends for their nimbleness and how they catch the ball downfield. But occasionally we get a reminder that tight ends, they've got that tough guy aspect too. How about him catching that short one there, shaking off tacklers, and turning that into an expansive gain downfield.
Goff on first down.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
We've got to give out a little applause on that play. It has to go to the defense. More good work by them. They've taken away the passing lanes all game long. And you can see the frustration that it's causing because he just about threw that one into the first row. DC, DC.
Throwing again on second and 10. Goff. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
On first down, gone. Being chased out left. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
Dancing to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, They're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. There's Goff. Touchdown! DeAndre Swift, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Lions are once again going to retake the lead. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And it's caught inside the 5. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more.
All right, partner, one more time. Our whole lives, you put the ball to 3-yard line, kick the extra point. 2015, they put it on the 15 to kick the extra point. 2016, they said, we're leaving it there. So if you want to fake it, that's a long way to go. And they got it done.
I was going to say, they had a 15-yard play in their back pocket.
You don't see that on too many play sheets, do you?
No.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
From the 35 on second down, Brady. Oh, that'll be incomplete.
Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. So a good run by Fournette. Now another 1st and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back.
Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Tampa Bay.
Leonard Fournette, for a big back, he can cover a lot of ground, and he showed off the athleticism there as he broke off a big one.
And what was impressive to me is not just how much he wanted it, but how he fashioned it. I mean, he was shedding tacklers left and right, evading tacklers left and right. And when you think about the energy it takes to ward guys off, that's really impressive. He still managed to keep his balance and turn this into a fantastic run.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. The big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. A shotgun snap for Goff. Flushed out right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
A good action to this point in the third quarter, just a 3-point game, 2nd and 10. Goff now looking to throw. He's going to air one out. And he fires one that's intercepted.
Picked by Antoine Winfield Jr.
And what a return as he brings this all the way back down to the 20-yard line. I tell you what, credit is due there on them preventing the touchdown after that interception.
How about him chasing him down and not giving up the pick six? Because what happens a lot of the time is when you see the interception, you just kind of hang your head a little bit and you momentarily pause because you're frustrated. He shook that off and gave great chase.
And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Leonard Fournette taking it in from the 20. And the Bucs capitalize on the short field as they take it in for 6. Extra point put through by Succop. And his guys will take a 10-point lead.
And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. No run back here for Raymond. This will be a touchback. Offense ready to kick off their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah!
Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Now he dumps this off over the middle, and he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll fake the handoff. Now Goff. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Play action. It's Goff. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to fire one. Corner of the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And the Buccaneers are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
When he went on the move there and started rolling out, I thought there was a window, but that window closed quickly. Intercepted.
And sometimes, despite how big your arm talent is, you don't get enough on a throw when you're on the move as opposed to setting your feet and stepping into one. That may have been the case there, and the defense certainly benefited.
He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. From the 29, Brady. They'll swing this out to Fournette. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. Clock running under 4 to play now as they come up on first and 10. They'll try and run some clock with Fournette. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. On this day, the ground has been his, but at least on that individual play, we just saw the defense finally with a win.
Yeah, they finally got one, and that's a win for them. But all game long, he's seen the holes, and they've been huge for him. Kind of like a baseball hitter in the zone. The ball seems bigger, and he's just whacking it. These guys, they've got it going today.
Meanwhile, Brady's throw complete here, pulled in by Howard. And he'll be stopped right at midfield.
A gain of 15. And a Buccaneer first down.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
A 3-yard pickup.
On second and 7, Brady airing this one out for Evans. He's got a man complete. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. A big play that time through the air. 34 yards.
That seemed to me to be all about trusting your receiver.
No doubt about it, because when he put that ball in the air, I will guarantee you everyone who's watching this game right now thought, that's up for grabs. But this is a lot of practice time.
And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans there to make the grab. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. Extra point up and good by Succa. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17.
Bradley Ashley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. Detroit offense ready to begin their drive.
And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, what's...
And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Shaquille Barrett in there to take him down on what will take us to the two-minute warning. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
Goff's throw taken in by Hockenson here.
A good pickup there, 18 yards as they get closer for third down. From the gun, here's Goff. Flush to his right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And boy, possession here turns over with the football already being in the red zone. Fournette, a first down carry. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Now Leonard Fournette. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
Brings up second and goal at the Lions' 10-yard line.
Brady going to look to throw. And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucks. Mike Evans, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bucks are going to add on to their lead. Extra point put through by Succop. And the lead is now 24.
42, Lions 18.
Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away.
And it'll come out to the 25 as Raymond will elect not to bring it out.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Off play action. Here's Goff. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And the Bucks come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuh. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip a in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I been, check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, and that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory till the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a mind and have you salty as a bacon rind. I'm trying to mastermind how to help out humankind. I'm open mind, but I do not walk with none aligned. My state of mind is to keep a peaceful peace of mind. I'm like Malcolm with my peace at the Venetian blinds. I'm trying to manifest some things in my subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams in my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, swing the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework, I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
Up north, brick roads. I got the pump in the making jump. Chris Crown. Don't you ever get a Chris Crown. Don't you ever get a Chris Crown. I got the pump that to make you jump. Don't you ever get a Chris Crown. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the count. I find then I get loud. Lift up. It ain't nothing to cut the out. Stop frying, don't let it get soft. Covered in yolk, in yolk. Wonder why I got the whole world pissed off. That's how I'm feeling. Dog, that's how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League takes us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the San Francisco 49ers and the Los Angeles Rams. SoFi Stadium. And no run back on the opening kickoff. It'll come out to the 25. First carry for Cam Akers. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid gain.
On first down, they'll stay with Akers on the ground. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and three.
Second and three at the 46-yard line.
Out of the gun, Stafford. He'll get this one to Cobb, complete. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 36. Stafford going to give this to Akers. And he'll get down to about the 26-yard line. The last run got 9. That leaves him with second and a yard.
Brings up second and a yard.
From the shotgun, here's a give to Akers. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. They'll try and run for this with Akers. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. If you make the stop there, maybe you hold them to 3 on this opening drive. They didn't get the stop.
Yeah, new set of downs now. Now you're worried about, just as you pointed out, not just giving up 3, possibly giving up 6. Let's see what they decide to do here, because they've got to change up what they have been doing. It hasn't been working.
first carry now for the Memphis man, Darrell Henderson. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11.
That's good for LA
Rams. This is Henderson. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got 6, now second and 4. They'll run out of the gun with Akers. And he'll get this one back to the 5-yard line, but no further than that. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down.
Third down and
now Stafford. And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the Rams take it right down and score on the opening drive. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. First down is Lance, escaping the pressure right, and he wisely will throw that one away. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early, this offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense, but I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
Meanwhile, Lance's throw pulled in by Kittle. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
Lance to throw for it on 4th down. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. So from Rams territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 45-yard line. Now Lance. That's swung out to Mostert. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. Lance going to throw. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. It'll be a gain of 5. And that is going to set up a 3rd and 1. Now Lance again. This one into the hands of Kittle, the tight end. And boy, he is very close to a 1st down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. It'll be a gain of just a yard, and that's going to bring up a 4th down. He's going to let this go back of the end zone, and this is going to be intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And a very good return as he takes us all the way up to the 35-yard line. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts in drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-0 lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say, when you're running the big-time races. It means they got out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, 2nd and 10. Stafford now to throw. He's going to air it out deep for Woods. And this one is incomplete.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that one. He read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
Throwing on third down, Stafford.
That's into the hands of Akers, complete.
And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. Here we go on fourth, Stafford. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it, and it'll be a turnover on downs. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Flushed out right. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. 2nd and 10. Shotgun now for Lance. And right back to Kittle. This time he's got it. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. Lance now on first down. And this is incomplete. Oh, he had 6 points right in his hands, but could not hang on. Here's 2nd and 10. Lance looks to throw again. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4.
First and goal, San Francisco.
Mostert. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. 2nd and goal from the 1. Lance looking to throw it. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. Interested to see what they dial up here. 3rd and goal with a lot of green between them and the end zone. Here's Lance to throw it. Buying time to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And the Rams are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And this offense last time turned it over, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows a coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that'll loosen up things a little bit, won't it? Maybe you'll play a little bit better the next time you have the ball.
44 yards rushing for him now in the ballgame. The Rams on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Now Stafford. Man open, it's Kupp. He's got it. Now he sheds himself free. Oh, look at the juke. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A big play there on the catch and run. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A 2-minute drill before the coaches.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And the Niners are going to get the football back at their own 17.
And that was one I kind of saw coming, Charge. He had a free safety just hanging back there over the middle, waiting. And he saw that ball go in the air, and he jumped on it.
And I don't know why the quarterback didn't see that. That was just your standard cover three, which means the free safety in the middle of the field, the two corners, and they divide the field in thirds. But when you have a free safety with range, like a good center fielder, he can go from side to side and make plays on the football, as he did there.
So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Eluding the pressure right. This one caught by Kittle. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. The Lance's throw taken in by Samuel. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
To throw again on 2nd down, Lance. He'll swing this out to Mostert. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5. Again, they'll throw it with Lance. And it's going to be incomplete. He was able to catch it there on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. And it's going to bring up 4th down. And they're going to go for this. Just 1 for 3 so far on 4th down tries. They're trying again. And they'll go for it. Lance. That'll be caught by Ayuk. Touchdown, 49ers. Brandon Ayuk, as the first half is winding down. And the Niners are on the board here in the final seconds of the first half. They'll try and run it up the middle. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. And this play is not going to work. He stopped short of the goal line, and this This will remain a 7-6 ball game.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Oh, the return is Brandon Powell. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with a one-point lead, you'd have to think they'll be looking just to get this to halftime. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
To throw on second and 10. Stafford. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Quan Williams. And he's giving his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. They'll spot it at the 30, so this is a 40-yard attempt. The kick by Gold is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports.
Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Gutten and Charles Davis.
And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gutten, getting set for quarter number three here. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it. But I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities. And I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
There's a ball thrown right side and complete. And all the way down to the 36-yard line. A big play there for the Niners.
They came out with an aggressive mindset to start the third quarter, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them take more of these type of deep shots as this game moves along. They connected there. They expect to connect on more before this one's over.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. That is caught by the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers.
We saw this plenty last year in college. He loved to take his shots downfield, and that throw, that was a thing to behold there.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it, here in the stadium, you could just sense the crowd thinking, oh, no. And their worst fears were realized as that one turned into a long touchdown.
They'll look to throw. And the Niners are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. So they try to make it a two-score game with a conversion. It pays off.
And they've looked at the situation, figured it out well. A two-score game in this situation, they've got to feel much better about where they are.
Here's Powell on the return. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really...
On Stafford for the third time is intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tartt. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
Boy, Charles, that is now three interceptions in three consecutive drives, and you can see he's just got a look of disgust and bad body language, understandably, as he walks off the field.
And I think it comes from the fact that he's not sure what he sees down the field, Brandon. I don't know if he's seeing ghosts. I don't know if he just can't read defenses. I'm not sure what it is, but that's why he's frustrated. Think about the defense right now. Every time they run on the field, they've gone from hoping to intercept the pass to expecting to intercept passes. Their confidence at an all-time high right now.
Off of play action, here's Lance. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Now after the sack, Lance and the Niners staring up here to third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball.
A deep ball down that right sideline, and he made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
So fourth and 15, but the offense is staying out there to go for it. And they fake the handoff. Now Lance. A hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. The Niners go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Rams are going to take possession of the turnover on downs. So good field position for the Rams as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. That'll leave them with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Throwing is Stafford. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
It's a gain of 22 yards.
They'll run on first down with Akers. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Now Stafford. He completes it to Beckham. And he will be brought down at about the 6 yard line.
It's a gain of 18. That's good for an LA Rams. First and goal at the 6 yard line.
They'll run here with Akers. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. Now it's Stafford. Firing quickly, but it's incomplete.
Well, they certainly did a nice job there picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with him. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
Six plays got him down here. This is play number seven, third and goal. They'll try and run. Henderson. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Darrell Henderson. An 8 yard touchdown run. And the Rams have got this back to a one score game.
But they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
And the kicker, this has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead is down to a field goal. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway.
And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down,
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence. There are so many things to watch for when you play defense, and reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him.
A run there with Mostert as he'll push this forward and call it a 4-yard gain on first down. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. From the gun, it's Lance. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle.
And that is caught at the 10-yard line. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
On first and 10, here's Lance.
That is caught by the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. George Kittle, a beast in the red zone with his second touchdown of the game. And the 49ers add six to their lead. Robbie Gould on for the extra point. And his guys will take a 10-point lead.
Makes the score Niners 24, Rams 14. Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away.
From the end zone, here comes Brandon Powell.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical.
He lost six there on the first down play.
Brings up second and 16 at the 14-yard line.
Looking to throw again on second down. Stafford, throw left side, complete to Cup. The Rams on third down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This will be third and 6. A shotgun snap for Stafford. Open man, Higbee, the tight end. And he is going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown.
Meanwhile, Stafford's throw complete there to Beckham.
And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
It's a gain of 28 yards.
Henderson now on first and 10. Tackle that time by Jarquiski Tart. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Here's Stafford. Oh, no, he lost the football. Oh, no, he lost the football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers. 30. Past the 20. And he will bring this one back. It's a fumble return for the 49er touchdown.
There you go. There you go.
The offense, they've had some sloppy moments. Sloppy there again on that one, and it could be the backbreaker.
From a defensive perspective, if the offense is going to be sloppy, you've got to take advantage of that. And that's what they've done all game long.
Now Gold for the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17.
Rams 14. Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. And they'll start at the 25 as Powell decides against returning it. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear them, the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. If we were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it.
Stafford's throw pulled in by Woods. 7 yards, the pickup there.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 43-yard line.
To throw again on 2nd down. Stafford. Got a man. It's Higbee complete. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. So from inside Niner territory now, this is 1st and 10 at the 34. Meanwhile, the throw here is complete. A gain of 6 there on 1st. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. To the air again, Stafford. Caught left side, it's Beckham. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 15-yard line.
10 at the 15-yard line.
From the red zone now, Stafford. And it's caught. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone.
13 more yards.
Here's Stafford. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Cam Akers. There to make the grab. And the Rams have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead is trimmed down to 10. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away.
Made at the 25-yard line. The Niners take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all 3 timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
After what they've faced during this game, where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, that has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
Steps away to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And got his man complete. The 49ers now going to use the 1st of their timeouts. It's just their 1st. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. That one looks like he'll throw here. This one caught by Kittle. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. That is caught by the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. George Kittle there to make the grab. And the Niners are able to stretch their lead. Gold able to tack on the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. It's a squibber picked up around the 27. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. What do you do here down like this in this situation? Do you maybe just pick something out of the playbook you haven't called in a while, or you call it a day?
You can do that, or you pick something that's a staple for you and should work better and try and execute that on the way out the door and maybe get back to base and feel a little bit better as you end a ball game that's been a frustrating one for you.
Yeah, we'll see if they go back to base. Throwing again on second down. Stafford, quick slant here to Woods. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ballgame. On first down, Stafford here. Over the middle and complete to the tight end, Higby. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field.
First and 10 at the 29-yard line.
Here we go, here we go.
Again, it's Stafford. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked by Tarvarius Moore. And the 49ers come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. So the victory here for San Francisco, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I'll bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in with a game.